3, 2, 1.
Interesting to me is that now this is a fourth rumble, and then the initial 3 years were more sort of about trying out something new, and this year for the first time I felt like now it's really part of us.
No, it's a German short hair. So first he has a 4-year-old. And he's wonderful, and he has a 4-year-old.
Jeff is very anxious about who's in the card is going to get the most play. So, okay.
Ocker is the new ochre.
Yes.
The new thing.
That's you.
That's me. Ochre is the new pink.
Yeah.
It's a 3-part series. Number 1, junior faculty heart building. Number 2, senior faculty heart nature. Number 3, who hearts ideas.
My card says this is not your Claude Parent's oblique function.
New Cinco. Sounds like you.
Yeah, that's NY Cinco.
New. Oh. That was my other card. See, there is such a thing as serendipity. Ah. But there were a few comments in these index cards about data. And about a data exhaustion, data entropy, is data research, you know, and I would go so far as to say the spectacle of data, the spectacularization of data has come to substitute for any kind of content whatsoever.
You know, what I care about is someone who
loves pink and hates ochre.
I don't know about anybody else here. I'm just totally lost. I have no clue what you guys are talking about. The notion of data is a generic thing, is the most absurd thing I've ever heard. The notion of pink, the notion of even color, discussed at this time in history in terms of the role of an architect, seems absolutely absurd, completely absurd. The generalities of slick or smooth or who gives a shit, that's your opinion, I don't even care myself. Where is architecture's role? Not one word has been said.
Isn't there a way so that next year, the fourth rumble, we don't have the same conversation about you guys are too slick for your own good, you need to change it up, then when we do it looks awful. Where is it? Because I think it's about...
Get some different guests.
What we all did is looked at motion, both literal motion, and later we discovered phenomenal motion in architecture.
The atrium space relative to the whole building, I think, could have been much larger.
The topic that I've been dabbling with for a while, but this research studio let me go fairly deep into it. And it's also because I want to start looking at robotic environments at UCLA at a bigger scale. This was a kind of first launch of that whole issue.
I did not give them a problem. We gave them a broad situation and a positioning within that cultural, social, political landscape. And that their job was, in fact, to initiate and to invent a problem, which is a matter of connecting a series of dots.
Our studios as a whole are talking about three Rust Belt cities, Toledo, Cleveland, and Flint, and although they face a lot of very similar issues, they've all adapted themselves very differently.
Because of the unbridled nature of our economy, our cities are so much more volatile, like a jungle or a forest that turns over, big areas change.
I want to come on these things not to know what I already know, but to be forced into knowing things I don't know.
The title of the studio is Eucalyptos. Eucalyptos is a place in Brazil, it's a favela. Favela is the term they use in Brazil for slums. And since it is a research studio, maybe part of the design work could be designing new approaches to research itself.
When I go around, let's say, the hallways and I bump into someone teaching, and I'll say, how's it going? If they usually say, I'm not really sure, I take that as a good sign. Because anytime anybody says, I know exactly what's going on, then essentially it's a vocational project, right?
As well, the idea
I kind of touched on it, but the idea that they're sort of marketing these communities towards this personality.
You want to gain more green space, right? That's the point. Okay, by doing places like Tokyo, the system, trains, and everything built up on top of that.
What you were saying about the figure, I think this one is quite successful. I mean, I wish there would have been a second instance of the entire thing put together, but it's, I think, quite successful in possibly defining interior figures.
I'm not interested in traditional juries of professionals giving criticism to younger students. I'm interested in juries that the people involved are participating in looking for responses to complex problems.
You don't want to hear only like a courtesy comment, but you want to hear actually more honest sort of comment about the school and the work produced by students, and that's why Rumble is here for.
It's the sustainable studio at UCLA. Okay, let's just get that on the table. Except we're trying to change the image on the one hand of sustainability through the problem of urbanism.
One of the questions that I have in terms of for the whole studio is in terms of what is the policy that you're setting up in terms of like how dense.
And the logic of a grid and axes, which you're still borrowing from very traditional urban planning where there's a grid, there are roads because cars have to get through. That should go away completely, and then your swarming should determine exactly the urban experience.
So we're working on an urban scale proposal for the city of Helsinki, for the entire historical port of Helsinki. And the idea to see is to see whether we can develop strategies that would work architecturally, but in a very, very large scale, urban scale project. And the overall aim of the project is somehow reinvent the port city for the 21st century.
TechCore marries our interest in technology with an interest in the role that the facade has in contemporary design research.
Rigid foam insulation is CNC milled into specific forms, and then that is wrapped, waterproofed, and strengthened with resin impregnated polyester roofing.
It's a subassembly that's then connected by a matrix, by a more expansive field.
Students were experimenting with the degree to which they could imagine new properties for a set of materials that architects have been grappling with for centuries.
And then here, looking at the section, you can actually see like what kind of space is created and how the walls come up and hit the airframe members to kind of enclose the space for more security and storage.
Project could really, I like it. It's weird.
Yeah.
Very weird.
Yeah.
Especially that plan.
It's the best, you know. It's one of the best drawings.
It has a nice video game aesthetic that I like.
The conversation can always go further. You can take the conversation right down to the significance of a doorway, or you can take right up to the significance of, you know, Northern European economics or anything in between. And you know, or memories of ships. So you can bullshit enormous, and you know, architecture's bullshit.
I'm just a huge fan of the Rumble as an event, as a kind of and of its staging, and the no architect can come into a place crawling with architectural work and not come out happy, even if you agree or disagree with the premises. But just the kind of presence of a lot of work and the presence of a lot of different kinds of work is exciting.
Our work here has always had a sense that design was in fact based in questions about the city, questions about society, questions about the environment. And in a quarter system, it's hard to get a hold of that. And some of the studios do a pretty good job, and we see that in Rumble, even with just 10 weeks worth of work. But there are other studios, ones that even have been coordinated with some seminars, that really show what intensive investigations can produce. And to have that be part of this beautiful rendition of us and the building and all the students' work is pretty incredible.
And you see all the progress of the student, now you feel like, well, I feel like now maybe it's a time to change and start new over and over. And that's the basic spirit of the Rumble. You know, once you see something is established, we need to kind of break it and then start new.
Come in.